Emma Missa Quinney is a member or member of parliament. Na the good thing is, me MC, a friend, Honorable Kofi Ofori. I friend Bella. I mean, Shirano. In fact, we have been very good partners. Na yen yin aye nim se ebani development a bain enshi shaya or yeno, usually or the fa through the municipal assembly. Inti one were MCE, if you're able to work together very well, we begin to see a lot of good things happening. Na one way nim menu omunim se me a action person. I don't make a lot of noise. But what I like and they say among for be with their eyes, what is going on? Now, say, Edu, Mira, Yako elections, sir. Who opponent, dear, who cost rubber form, Edu, any mutu chief form, and the crampo, and Yenefe. Intino, a ya, name crop, what dear, or mufra, or mobeca say, Yenyeshi. But, young fan said, there are two key things, sir. Meba, medici, meniso. Near di kaino. And Kitahua, my name and crop for Edi, ya, sana, omu yime as MP. Any campaign she share, ya, menu or more, Edi, kind as she share, you know. Titru no, we name me crampa, me mantra, a people first, me a part of the Hope campaign. Ya, ya, dear, and say, nipa, a win here first, because I come with the nipa. We see diamond or crampa, and yashi, mano. And ye di kind say in our first year, we're going to focus on economic empowerment.
Okay.
Na ye share how ye be making sure, say, especially ye mebunu, ebe nye juma, aye. Ena, ye honon so a lot of low income, any traders, ewo ho. And me set it out, say, within my first year, I will focus on economic empowerment, any jobs. And what we did was, yeah, we encourage people to be brave for themselves. So I came up with a grant program for the cells. Miami raises ka edema cells no say omunfa enye juma. Na me sanso e raise 100,000 cedis edema me markets for as a grant for them within themselves no. Omo de ma omo ho na omo ajijijiji back as omo ya ne as loans.
Say the biasi kanu enche.
And she na ama other people and so I benefit it. But me made the mawomo as grants.
Okay.
Inti, those are the in she share me yeah yeah. In fact, who share me the last 2 years see the number of encrofwa era ejumemu ewa blikuma north is unprecedented. The good thing is one more any ejuma ni na they are known people. Who compared to one besin kwa, especially my predecessor. Ono ne dia ne dia wuhu baabi a enkrofo ani fi you know and I do do ana so krampo no ubi sa wo mo so a mo se ah ya ne ya kwa kwa prayer de but me jidi say me ba ye ne dia adwuma bebre akoso in terms of job creation na ofa projects in so aye yeah that is the economic empowerment part yeah babe ye campaign me ye house to house just as most of us know. Ya kwa election na yeye. Na Ablikuma North community na nkasano. In fact, ye roads ye bad. Ube bisa. Before ame bana ne ye wa MP ana. I mean, so bit na hono mna wakase. MP na oba ye bia ye nye ye roads ni na. Na roads ni huwa miko tutu ye. Meka se. Hafe na meba besha se fufuro. Ni ya kakra ne wa hono. Meso me asedi ya ni se. Me de ba be ka ho. In fact, Osha Ablikuma North, apart from the major roads connected within the various electoral areas and any major ones, they say N1, any Malamodoko, those ones in the Abayneye, most of the smaller ones within Ablikuma North constituency, you know, they were done by my father. Or no, any Joe Apia, Abreso, and almost all those roads were created. There were some refurbishments that probably went on. I don't know. But in fact, who nemua on back our papa breso ni ye we o papa breso o papa breso wehu and se si edu menso meso se menso meye menso me
di. Oh dear.
Na me ba ye no me first assignments minya about 3 key routes.
Okay.
Now those routes are minya ye no it was only one of my contractors in a bar site because the other two no na they had outstanding payments, as I say, EBA. Inti ono ne di ano ne assign ne roots ewo sakamai electoral areas.
Okay.
Na eno nso echi no minya additional resurfacing from another MP. No wayan some projects are no ne resurfacing about 15 kilometers were outstanding.
Okay.
Inti ofre me na odi eno nso kame ho. Inti yekoye dakuman resurfacing ewo ho ye odoko some of the odoko routes ne so ye resurfacing ewo ho inti in fact we've done over 20 kilometers of roads in you know completing it since
the over 20 kilometers of roads you know roads are more constructing of for and as you mentioned the resurfacing part and so can
resurfacing was
15 kilometers
yes,
okay.
But the near constructing you know,
from the scratch,
five kilometers.
Okay.
And mostly.
But is there a challenge in getting a road constructed? Because one of the constituents, Binum Edin Koma, almost all of them are talking about, say, our members of parliament have not been doing well in terms of, say, a more constructive roads. Am I? What really is the challenge when it comes to getting roads constructed in some of these constituencies?
Truth be told, French is buying at as I say, wunya contractors are ibia omoya very very liquid.
Okay. Omuuska.
Na ya the contracts ni ma womoa omuye juma ibia ni etuya wonka.
Okay.
But obehwa and I say we all know say we've been through serious economic difficulties in the last 2 years. Meme ba ya no na ya COVID mu. I came in 2021. Because of my presence in India, ya na Crawford in some ache. Machawa system ni mupa debi. This is my third year. Wohu. In 2021, me ba yen and I was already in the COVID era. Now, within the COVID era, no, because of financial challenges, we nyaye ninti no. Dudwa na, no, mwayo contracts, ne, mse no, mu payments ye, outstanding. Enti, te se, me contractor ya, waye ejuma sakama nisi no. Agreement, ne, se, onuwa nebe tuwaso. Enti, ye ne, onuone, ministry aye san hyehyeye na ye hwie ni mu se some of the payments are all expected by obeba beto ane aka ne so because the other ones ni other contractors they never showed up. Even though
okay.
ye lobby wie ye na adwuma no e bai but omo intimi end
me
ba
okay
exactly enti in fact many me MCE aye hyehyeye se the last 2 years see yeah, common fund sky yen you sue yen. Your best share grading, I say. Your best yes, ye roots, Nesso, because your honey are very busy. You know, a dock hall, Utima, me, Kashiman areas, home crop for Fahopa. And it connects to a lot of other communities around us. Yeah, we are surrounded by 7 different constituencies. And you know, your inner roads, you know, apart from Dakuman, say, you know. Most of the ones that go through Odoko or near there, no, they are very bad. I see it me see roads ni bia ebema convenience
abba
eho. Inti ya drain say insio na etuton etia.
Okay.
Yebe fa graders ni you know rulers near there ni see ya kwine na ya ma a kwine aye mo trouble aye comfortable.
So that assurance is there. Say insio
masa
said that. Oh, okay.
As we speak, from Monday. And your friend is saying me MC release equipment nearby.
Okay.
Into say na ya ye odoko ye major connecting routes na ya ye no and ya ye tree mami. And so the no ye ye tree mami ya kwaya nyameche.
Okay.
And also was a very bad road they call mambo. Yes, so see how fast we in fact yeah speed ramps cry. Yeah, assembly members say ebano.
Okay.
Yeah, more munye na ye speed ramps or so cross see how nam so avi. And there, Omuya knew your more cockashiman. You so I need to see some areas of being too. And see, these are a year, a day, a common fund, a ye, Sanya Bayer, your Hono, your roads and Crawford, Etafa, Efaso, a war, a Blickman of constituency, no, those roads and a ye
will be more trouble.
Exactly. What better so recently, you see, traffic lights, road na. What your traffic lights in Asia etutu so badly. In fact, those roads have been bad since before I'm a MP. the first work I me yeah 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 Hansonic Junction. Mm. That place, no, near me, maybe toast, no, it was terrible. It was terrible. And they be kasa yeah, yeah, or munya measured kakra because near yeah, yeah, toast, no, was so much worse. And I am a minister of roads or no, I buy it, or behave no, send your hornety. A horned year, you were a bit of a problem or techno side, no, because of your drainage systems in your home. But here to me, see a while, and also a you okay, but anytime I see you better to tunnel. Now, why son, I say beam into ye honey ye. But now traffic lights in Ankasa or Doko, any the command junction, maybe a total filling station, honey one. In fact, near honey would do what I say swimming pool near
you. In your turn at time.
Nay, yeah, but not go slower, but motorway power goes slower, but so. But in Yami Adam and also Minister Shay, ye see honey na. In fact, na kwa first light, no nya me constituency, but ya yesie ninyi na.
Okay.
Bits and pieces are car on the side routes no, and also a part of the whole project on Moye. Na yenso ya sign ashishe within Ablekuma North constituency no so ye pache most of your roads no within the constituency are asphalt. It was so that you know potholes are
big.
Yes, yes, yes. Ninjana. There are a lot of works ongoing. And I am sure I would say the good news in so about the barnyard traffic
light. Traffic light.
And also, Nyami Adam. And your good news for a lot of people.
After three solid years.
You know what I mean? These things have lasted for so long. But interestingly, there were actually two problems that you see. First one, an accident. Somebody actually drove into the system. I want to say, a solar-powered system. Into a wall, apart from the cabling, the batteries are power. First one, accident, NACA, somebody drove into it, and then they had to come and fix it. It took some time. A buy and chebia, and a chrome for.
A buy.
No more, much you check cables, no cables are connected underground, no much you check, and no movie, no museum via batteries. And this was done in broad daylight. And you know, because now Crawford Edwin say ECG workers in Abba because they were wearing their vests and all of that. And your mobile and mobile to two batteries need to be a decoy. Now, it cost the government almost $1 million to fix those particular issues. You know, now, yet the Minister of Roads, I say, because we are roads and highways for Adia, Tia da Omwasi, so on mobile, yeah, on mobile base, yes, I must say. I was shifoni. In fact, the whole of Ghana and Accra, one way of feminine, they say, dear, we are assured, say, a horn problem be any ho, ya share, they say, BBI is stable, yeah, Juma. And see, in fact, they say, the Ablekuma North is taking ship.
It's
taking ship. And I keep saying, and ra, omuya Juma, you know, I'm new, omon and nam, to engage my people.
But honorable, the traffic light issue. No? I know, it's not your responsibility to fix a yeah, traffic lights. But I didn't chair, sir.
Department of financial issues.
Urban roads. Trunk rata the comma urban roads for. No, mosi chamba kwa koye.
Medanyami has to say, you know how much work has gone into it because people don't appreciate. People don't appreciate it. Say, only buying a BBI is not a one-day thing. And a plus, it's not only a bureaucracy, but then also, as I say, I appreciate it. Say, the country really has been through economic challenges. Into a do point, BBI, all the ones in the crack or two table news where nobody wants to hear because, see, can you hear? But it's say, you know, you're done, you're me, and you're picking up. That is why I hear him say, a lot of the things are picking up. I just want to encourage Crawford say, "Munya butrema abaino," because whether it is MPP, NDC, whoever it was, anke, whatever we have been through so far, no, there is nobody who could have done a better job than what we are doing. Ejuma ya ye, I will share your track recorder. Who to me who said the gaps came in only during the timer? All these economic challenges happened, and it was just not in Ghana; it was the whole world. But they say in Nsua, and near my air pick up, and the union I had the new who say, and Kakrana, and near my air conning. And see, yen yarish, mukakra, say, and near my becosu, I ye, Ediamagana.
Yeah, your constituents are actually following the conversation this morning. Mamenchia Yablikuma North constituency for Nina. There are also some of them are also asking specific questions. Ebi said they would want to know the roads resurfacing in the Yablikuma North constituency. This one is also coming from Abrante Efreno Wahine Akwasi Echampon Kwache. He also wants to know any padodua what provide employment for in the constituency. But I think that some people are also responding to his questions that he's asking. Ohema ya dufua fusu. Techno Road has been fixed by Urban Roads and Sonic was done. The municipal chief executive has revealed that traffic light that went off in 2021. Has been fixed already. Alex, I broke fresh. I say, Honorable Shilaba tells for MP for Yablikuma North constituency, thank you for giving over 35 youths permanent government jobs. On also, there were day ever. Okay. As I say, if I'm watching you live inside the chairman, in regards to Amma from Pong Esquire, incoming member of parliament for Sunyan West. Okay, you can keep sending in your messages. If you have any question for Honorable Yeshila Batel's Member of Parliament for Yablikuma North constituency, will be to me at the about Honorable Pacho. I don't know whether if you would want to respond to some of these issues. Hey. See, the 15-kilometer road more resurface here in Yablikuma North constituency. Some people are asking if they would want to know the areas as a resurfacing in Ekoso.
Mori.
Okay.
Mori Road.
Okay.
Odoko. The names no. Parliament House Road in Efe Nimwa Edeko Kokosi Marshalls University. Okay. I think that one is Owusu Kofi Street. Okay. I think so.
Okay.
In fact, I don't know the names so well.
But at least there is evidence.
Yes.
Of course.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So there is evidence that these rules have been resurfaced, isn't it?
Yes.
Honorable, let's.
Mami responded to another one. Irebi Ekaka who say, Urban Roads. You see the funny part about me opponent in Crawford. When you me opponent in Crawford, I have to respond to them. You see, if there is a problem, Mobeka say MP. But then when the MP goes and pushes for the solution to come, then you say Urban Roads. Does Urban Roads work in a vacuum? Somebody has to go and speak. And somebody has to follow up. Into me ko na me ko kan na me push na minister ka so beya na me this me MCE ni me team o ma follow up. And that is why you are seeing development. When you have a good team like this now, and one na wudi be hu na eche o ka say Urban Roads are no problem. Urban Roads na e ba beya road no. But at the end of the day, you have the power of the leadership of the constituency to make sure you say development.
I think it's true that some of these things do not happen in vacuum. For us at Happy FM, when we wanted traffic lights to be fixed, we didn't just go anywhere. We wrote to the appropriate entities and the quarters for directives to be given to certain departments for them to go and fix the roads. So obviously somebody must take the lead and ensure that some of these things are done. But Honorable, it looks as if
hey, me call Papa. Because man kwa ye jawa mahoy. Me call. It is very, very, very important. They say ye bet why you juma ye.
Obi ma fans was it about be campaign the amount. But Yamra, your work as a parliamentarian.
Now umayenka.
Okay, so let's finish with within a year Yablikuma North constituency. No?
It's very
apart
very
from
important.
apart from roads, and apart from the provision of employment to a year constituents or more constituency.
Yes.
What are the other things that ABA, a year Honorable Sheila Batels, aya nipa pi noa in share within the constituency?
I want to look at education,
okay,
for instance. Me share say and so on say my constituency, no, we have a very huge population that is illiterate. Into if I say you best support it both on the basic level, SHSD and Yamia Dum, and because of His Excellency Nanadu, president his vision into say SHS free.
Free.
But of course, and Crawford SHS na say support you more because who kwa unti mean found sapin enko. Enti no na my SHS packages I am medema SHS. One more echo provisions our mude echo school. Mema grants for universities.
Okay.
One more echo universities to support them. And I'm missing some my basic school support for school fees.
Okay.
And also to the extent my education director cry complaining. Say me yen too much because I had to say me j responsibility
from
of parents.
The parents you know.
But I feel say me hono. The real challenge is if you don't support the parents na emofrane ebeka, and then we will still have that cycle of illiteracy. Inti as I said, ye force na ye boa. Nyamiado me mami enu from the constituency, omo were given scholarships to the UK to do their master's degrees. It's something I'm very very proud of. In fact, one of my teachers, Krampo, so on also ko US to teach there. It is something because of course it's improving the human resource
in your constituency. Yeah.
It do be easy time. May me have free classes at the ma emofrano. In addition to the usual yema womo tools near the so mo fanye, you know, I give them free classes to add to it. In fact, my money bebre call very good schools now, and it's something I'm extremely proud of. By 5-10 years time no in big that's what I want to see. And prospectors and so you know and also your supporting when they are going to school. Last week Makati said yesterday construction on a toilet facility for Wesley Grammar School. That's the only SHS in my constituency. And you know many akohopa say meboa amomoye top class into
your this baby grade A.
Yeah, this yeah, penisa into your the smart classrooms, baho.
Okay,
the digital libraries, baho. In fact, I'm fitting digital libraries in 3 of my basic schools.
Okay,
and then I'm
so 3 basic schools in here, Diani. Apart from a year, Wesley Grammar, I said we fix it, library, virtual library, or no.
Smart classrooms.
Oh,
yes. Yeah, be Kwashiman.
Okay.
Kwashiman Basic School.
Okay.
Yeah, be Odoko McLean.
Okay.
And yeah, be St. Stephen's.
Okay.
And also, yeah, smart classrooms for them. So, where you can learn robotics near their STEM program. And Baho.
Okay.
Those 3. Odoko Salaria.
Odoko Salaria.
We actually are setting up 2. Ewo Odoko Salaria.
Odoko Salaria.
But I have a pet project to be a meba beye. Ewo Kwashiman. Na enono is both a resource center, but then in addition to the resource center, and so it will be it's a 3-story digital center.
Okay.
I enono apart from the your friend saying the computer lab and library where you can just go to me, I could use the computers and why, yeah, we see you at the end. And also, we would have a classroom which is also smart. Inti, and one is one of my legacy projects that I want to do.
Alex Abrok Fresh, or say her love for education is a top notch scholarship for both local and international support for students, first class toilet facilities, and virtual libraries. And I think there's somebody who is in your constituency. Our Hunia, you know. And what day a yes and same way about yakan about education, we've spoken about roads, we've spoken about economic empowerment, which was the first thing that you touched on, which is very critical. And also you want to improve on the lots of the people within your constituency by improving their capacity to do things for themselves. Apart from these things that honorable, why within the constituency, you know, what else are in the pipeline for the constituents of Ablikuma North constituency?
Yo, your honor, so the Sewinim Hoi, I will say, yes, I say a big issue. But Nyamiadum, Wesley Grammar, as I so am I as a sick seer for an astroturf. In fact, your honor, ye nibi. And your friend is a Kwashiman, Park Nesusanki, the Bay astroturf. But then the honor. umbe assessment no mu say there are some issues inti inti minye yekohwe odoko salaria school no so enu so sa but Wesley Grammar my virgin land cra
okay
ye babe ye AstroTurf.
AstroTurf. Oh, Wesley Grammar.
Oh, Wesley Grammar.
For the yeah,
for the community.
Community.
Because
okay.
Because I want to know yenya asase kesiye sa. Yes, so ababe ye market. Eno the Ministry of Local Government. And I ababe refurbish ye market. Dakuma market. Edi amaye. Inti eno so is in the pipeline. Inti those are two major things for this year. Niyamike njina ye this
for this year.
Yes.
Okay.
This year. Ejuma mepesi ye ye ansana. Afina ND. Next year, dear Zubeba.
Next year, dear Zubeba. You're back next year, dear
Zubeba. Mami, fa we soon pim so. Nyamia drum ye MCE. We see hospital, municipal hospital. Ewo, awo shibany yard.
Okay.
Ehwana. In fact, I suppose we are three story. Ye re first story, no. Na my role in that is I'm supporting with all the equipment that is going into the hospital.
So they are building the infrastructure.
Exactly.
You're supplying that.
Exactly. Now, yes, since we renovated two blocks, Bako, Ewo, Odoko 4 and 5, school, Honum, you're renovating. And yes, since we renovating McCarthy Hill Basic School, you're renovating when you're finishing another one, which announced me a digital center, Ewo, Honum, Edia Mamofrano. Now, yes, since we completed two structures, one in Odoko 4 and 5 school honum in addition to Kwashima Ninsu, ya lifted another one in so every and when municipal assembly no and a complete is our project in Edema in Tias for education. We want to make sure say your honey dear, your best say baby ya na your manu omwinia ji school kohu.
Honorable Sheila Batel, say a member of parliament for Ablikuma North constituency. Interesting conversation we're having. Constituents are also participating in the conversation. Some are still asking questions. Some are also looking for clarification to a year and Simbia. Honorable Abosso Ohima, yeah, say the urban roads issue. The contractor said they were fixing roads all over the country. Nobody came to them to, nobody came to them, please. Okay. Through her efforts, two brilliant constituents have received scholarships to study abroad, opening doors to global education and opportunities. One other constituent is currently in France to also pursue higher learning. Another has been assisted to get a job in the United States of America as a teacher. Your second term is assured from Righteous Amuzu. Righteous Amuzu. Good afternoon, going out to you. Alex, may God bless this member of parliament. Her retention is highly assured because the youth are waiting for our AstroTurf. Sheila, Honorable is not telling the truth. The 20-seater and those infrastructure going to Wesley Grammar SHS are not projects. Hey, the toilet facility is being sponsored by the NLA. And the other facility is being done by
PTA. Now, why not? It was... If you really want to fire NLA, by oh, come on.
Eddie NPP. Sheila Batel's God sent indeed Ablikuma North. We are grateful to her. Humphrey Amwa, Mac Johnson. Honorable kudos. She's touched a lot of lives. Her constituents love her. The second term is definitely assured. Alex John, one thing I like about Honorable Sheila Batel is she's honest and real. Okay, these are some of the messages I'm reading, but I know it says a lot more are coming in. I've not opened the phone lines for you to call in to ask any question or whatsoever. When the time is due, I'll let you come in. Happy 98.9 FM. Happy morning show. Yeah, guest, Honorable Sheila Batel, a member of parliament for Ablikuma North constituency. Honorable, we've touched on a lot of the things that you're doing, and you mentioned that there are a lot of things that are in a pipeline in 2024. Obeye Ama or constituent. But within the constituency, party, no, it didn't break it saying, Emuya Kama Kama, dear.
Oh, and not dear. Young funny say, your car MPP, Ablikuma North, the MPP zone. A honey dear, young funny say, me papa, Abresono, and a fee, and this in some at the bar MPP side. Now, in fact, anytime I miss see a bonting, I'm a name crop for a bidding kit at home. Obi as overpower him, oh papa dear. Hey, Papa, dear, no, I'm a down for no, you mean ya. Oh, Papa, dear, no, I dine with her. Everybody has a room for my father in their house. Hey, I did be a me wonder, say, Papa, or anything. One in the cotton, I say, cancel, I remember myself. But I think, say, he did a fantastic job, say, or convert here, Osha, even one more, or your name, some way, NDC for Crampono. They love the family. Where home because of my father. And you know, the way omone ye kasamuni and jijesu ye ni muse ye hoarding ye. Once we continue to maintain relationship, no, just as he did, I think say we would be able to keep it as an MPP, as an MPP zone. MPP.
But does your father's work as a member of parliament in the same constituency put any pressure on you?
Absolutely. Once I make papa buy, you know. Or by a street, no, a minister of works and housing. So, Obeka, ain't you know, I say he didn't have half of the challenges I have because me minister of works and housing. But the good thing is that because of the goodwill, the fact is, I have my own relationships across board. My colleague ministers, I have good relationships across board. Oh papa. And then myself, I'm able to use that to push for a niyama for my constituency. I think, say, the goodwill, and I'm riding on the goodwill. And I'm going to say, I don't think I would have been a
good.
So I give that credit to my father. And also say, Oba, you know, one man may say Nechi, but Nechi, he built very, very, very good structures on which me age 90. I give him so much credit for that.
Jones, I'll say the rate at which suitably qualified young people in public one have been assisted by Honorable Sheila Batels to get jobs is unprecedented. FDA, GSA, Lands Commission, Security Services, Private Sector, Goyle, Teaching, Plain, Tichila, Twaso, Jones, Diawa, D, Esuma, Eba, Ye, Enono. But, Honorable, you're free constituents, Gakranian, your work as a member of parliament, you've been championing a year, Emma, say, Emma, Dium, Hubeshe, a year, Bibi, Biara, Ye, Ewa, Omaimo. Your co break bar, we will touch a bit on your work in parliament and some of the advocacies that we see, say, visibly, you've been championing. Our parliament. Happy 98.9 FM. As soon as which nah and Chebia, some of the articles that I've been reading about you was mentioning about the fact that you are championing Emma Nkanko, not just in parliament but across. Would you say Emma as a society, I empower enough to take up some of the positions are now advocate to say taking? Particularly, you also spoke about recently about Emra. A border on sexual harassment. Dear, Dawa Kuma Swa, Honorable, what can we say? Mieni, Sansi, Mihunkomoka Kawadaroma.
Yo, Sefa, Medase, Enna, this particular topic, as you know, me are very, very passionate about it. Nienti, I'm here passionate in the sense, you see, call most of the SHSs. In fact, me old school, Achimota School, a lot of the former male. Houses have been converted to female.
Okay.
It should show you that a lot of girls are getting into schools. Of course, the female population of Ghana, we actually have a higher female population than we have males.
Mm-hmm.
If all of us are getting into school at the basic level, all the way into SHS,
mm-hmm.
what happens at the top? Because once you get to the top, you see all men. And in fact, in my work as an MP, organizations are Masra as part of my work as an MP, supervision work near there. Most of the boards, when you go to their meetings, ubehu mema, majority, aye mema. If you have a high female population, what happens in the middle that causes a man to disappear?
Mm-hmm.
Inti ye hun say e ya na structures na ye wono. It is not necessarily Obi fault, but then it is more of the cycles we have gone through, and then the way and manner in which we are brought up. No, it causes most of women to believe say they have to stay in the background, especially when you have a very voracious and that's a difficult environment where typical decision makers are men. The spaces are here considered mostly for leadership. You see, say the decisions are made primarily with men in mind and women as an afterthought. And that is what we have to change because it's a mindset thing. But then we'll share also in our governance structure now. Mm-hmm. We'll say we have a ministry for women and gender and then
children.
Yes. But then we'll share the advocacy for women participation in both governance and mostly in the leadership space, and then also ensuring, say, workspaces are safe for a man to thrive without the feeling of intimidation or, you know, any other difficulties. I would to me who say, we are not doing enough for women to be able to get to the top. And see, there has to be a voice for that. There has to be a voice. Now, what I have set also is on my mind to push in parliament as much as I can. And say, every sector has to have a consideration for the growth of women. Mm. And necessarily making it an intentional agenda. Affirmative action bill has been there for a very long time. Mm-hmm. We haven't touched it. Because those who push it, Osha parliamentar, 275 parliamentarians, 40 women out of that. That is about 15%. And we are supposed to at least get to 30% of women representation. Meanwhile, Osha Krampa within yen as women ne krampuno. The challenges are yenya as female MPs. We don't get any support. Because most decisions are made when the boys are hanging out. Let's go and have a drink. That is where a lot of decisions are made. Usually you don't have women there.
You're excluded.
And then sometimes Nukra will share, and I keep saying this crap. You read the budgets, your state of the nation, and most of the major programs are or parliament are the public attention about parliament is what. Ube who say even the conversation is geared towards men contributing rather than women contributing. The other day, I'm a leader, discussion. Can I say, leader, why don't you force it such that when a man speaks, a woman must speak. When a man speaks, a woman must speak. Then whatever the case, all the 20 or 40 women in parliament will have an opportunity
to speak
on every single topic that comes to parliament. The women are more visual and then they are able to also make the kind of impact you hear. Because really, every sector, we need to have something that advocates for women participation. If you go to the boards, say yenya kanisana, then it becomes an intentional agenda. Ah, ye wose ye bema emana abasro. Because maybe a wobia obao. Yenim say politics, emma and a driving. Yenim say ye call most of educational systems, educational uko schoolsa. Wose
emma
call all the way to the professor levels. Mm-hmm. Inti baby, are you creating intentional space for a man? Be able to move say, Emma thriving, in your family. You see that Emma, your mother, is the one that is the center of it, and she brings a lot of warmth and comfort. And that is the same thing we can bring to governance. Inti where you see wars, you will not see that a woman is leading where there is war. Where there are challenges, there's always men. Inti we believe say when we include women. And we let women participate more. It's not to push men out. Because sometimes, you know, it seems as if men are intimidated by more women coming up top. But that's not it. It is more about we partnering with the men, we having our voices also heard, because the voice of a woman is distinctively different from the voice of a man. And when I say it that way, what I mean is the mindset of a man is different from the mindset of a woman.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you have a higher population being women, and men are the ones making the decisions for the men, it means that at every point in time, the perspective of the woman does not come into play at all. And you and I agree that women are the peacemakers.
Mm.
And so if we want a very sound, if anything, country developing for the good of all of us, we must make an intentional effort to include women and make sure that women are also in leadership and their voices are heard at the table.
But these are found in the Affirmative Action Bill.
Yes.
Why is it that we hardly hear a lot about the Affirmative Action Bill? The assumption that a lot of us, you want to say, Anke ma ewo parliament India, consistently, they will try to push the agenda to the fore, say the ebeya inyinaibitimi asumu neyabwa, to ensure that the bill is passed into a law.
There is so much that we have to deal with in our constituencies and making sure, say, our constituencies get the necessary development. We don't get enough room to be able to champion some of the causes we are so passionate about. Because you have to focus on getting roads. You have to focus on getting streetlights. You have to focus on, you know, getting your children into jobs and schools. And so it takes up all of the time. And anything that requires so much additional effort may kind of say the population of men, if you're coming to push anything, you need a lot of the men to participate. Mm-hmm. You need the men to also be part of driving it.
Mm.
And what is the interest of the man to make sure that there are more women? How will we say, for instance, 30% of MPs have to be women, for instance?
Mm.
Why not? Obeka said they are giving up their seats so that only a woman or only women will
occupy those seats.
So structure, there's a lot of structures that need to go into place to make sure, say, we are not only pushing for women, but we are pushing also for the quality that we are looking for in representation, because that is very important.
Will we ever have the Affirmative Action Bill passed into law?
It will be. It will be. I believe that our leaders, we have only one woman on our side who is one of the leaders in parliament. On the minority side, the deputy, they also have one woman.
One woman, yeah.
So the onus really lies on them to drive it at their end.
But how are you letting the men in parliament buy into this particular agenda?
That's why I'm saying that, you know, the women caucuses are the ones who have to present the agenda.
Mm.
And even though we have discussed it, we've had so many economic challenges. It's like, you know, bread and butter issues are so critical at this time. We see how our people are struggling to, you know, some people having a meal a day and all of that. So sometimes some of these bread and butter issues rather come to the forefront, and you end up, you know, giving that one more attention than those the other things that we feel are also important, but can actually wait.
I want us to get a little bit personal. How has it been, you know, transitioning from corporate world into politics? You've been in parliament. How difficult or easy has it been for you?
It was like being thrown into the ocean at the deep end. I have learned a lot.
Okay.
I have seen myself as a learner. Me hune say bibia if I'm coming a se misuya adie se me hu me ho as obi a mi besuya
adie. Okay.
Se me hu me ho as obi a for the people who have been in it for a long time or mona se misuya e
wo
mo ho, but at the same time to be as discerning as possible, say I won't lose the values that I have, both, you know, my personal values and also what I perceive to be the best thing in terms of making sure, say, development comes to my constituency. May share the challenges. Now, in fact, most of them now, may minimum say, yeah, challenges and sana, maybe I'll be a MP. No, may discover a lot more.
Okay. Did they all the no? Existence ones and what's saying, well, will be in the account.
And you need to strike a balance because at the end of the day, you know, I say, you say, your resources as a country and not soon. Meanwhile, every constituency is also, you know, fighting for it. And, you know, Obia pray the same little resources are, yeah, well, sometimes you have to look out of the box. You have to, would to me use it, for instance, my corporate network to get some of the supporter, yedinya. Projects into the constituency. And yama yebe yama yembebnu ama omu enye juma nase omu enya support omu dia yo omu business ni adie. Those sa support ni yina miminyano from my network in the corporate world. For instance, ni ayedie ye markets enye markets di ene grants na medema me sales no.
Okay.
Enu say in my corporate network. And support here, me de ye ye. Na me say no, me ye fintech. I come from the fintech industry. His Excellency Dr. Baumia, ya ye nim say digitalization no or no net driving. That is my sector. And one I'm out for the past 20 years.
That's great.
Na me who say near na me defeat the corporate sector no is also very, very useful also in parliament because. Parliament is representing all of the different sectors. The use of digitalization at this particular time, at this particular point in time, and especially with the Vice President driving this agenda, apart from say, may advocating for Emani Amanonsono, may advocating for fintech and digitalization also in Parliament. Which has to do with digitalization. Me who say in Parliament also I drive it. Nancy ya me catch me caucus say as I say yen require AI training because you share the way our AI drive it in the future now. And check ye be mra that has to do with AI. And as I say making sure say we have adequate knowledge about it. So those are some of the things that from the corporate sector into the public sector no, we are able to drive. But whatever the case is, the public sector and the private sector are two very different spaces. And I will encourage those in the private sector, say, if you don't know, learn about the public sector.
Before?
Yes, because a lot of the frustrations are yenya as private sector players. It is because we don't understand the way the public sector works. And yenya tiasia. Ebe buyen send ye beya yebi to me position ye your friends and your businesses. Na ye to me a partner with government to do the development. Because a lot of things are as private sector players no. We ye nti a memoasi. Inti at every point in time, you know, we are standing, we are shocked.
Having experienced the two. If you're to choose, Cecilia, which of them will you choose? Private sector or the public?
I'll still choose where I am now, but I know, say, Mivia, I will go back into the private sector private because sector. I will be wiser.
Okay.
I'll be wiser. And I think, say, a lot of private sector people, you shy away from public sector because it's very noisy. But may I encourage a lot of the private sector players, say, participate. Don't... One will say, you move baby, I don't want to hear about the politics. I don't want to hear, it's too noisy. And really, it is. Because we have peace of mind now, they are doing how I'll make one CD today. And our public sector, private sector, and so, such that, so when you scar, what do you mean to our workers? There's no break.
And the pressure bounce. So.
Yes. Inti, say, or more better, send your private sector, public sector, a functioner, or more TSE, yeah, it will help them in how. Or more present your more products, new more services, nay, send your more lobby government, near there for projects, near the no moving who, how, ombe and yama be brave more businesses, not
Honorable Sheila.
And let me add this, Mr. Oh, say, they be buying by because the private sector is the engine of growth.
Of growth,
but
yes.
There's a lot of things that are missing. In for which reason are not unemployment and so are very, very high. His Excellency Dr. Baumia a meeting with the fintech sector, and because I was part of that meeting. Na mihu tesasania or no engage private sector no obisa about policies, any programs are abine ya drive digitalization any on one kasa ni ni adie hunu. How will the two of us be able to work together? Yes, Anna. I think, sir, that is the key. That is a missing piece. Ebema private sector no a benefit from government, and then government in so able to me push in agenda, especially in job creation.
Okay.
So that omo ya omo plans now omo share. How do we create 1 million jobs, for instance? Edina buying here, and how do we put the two together so that we work as partners?
So collaboration is key.
That is the future.
Collaboration is key. Honorable Sheila Batels, that can basically be a phone line. So my man for free with questions. But as a brand call, or the assempa kwam your worry is in your constituency.
Okay.
Now, question back or the estima by any. Or say, please ask Honorable about sporting activities in her area. Or the assempa kwam your worry. Or now, or yeah, head of sports. It will happen 98.9 FM. Now, or say, a good day near Goframason, some at the same a your constituency, or so, and Sanya Serge Medina. So,
my constituency, dear, in fact, a good day, Mimi, who say it to a football.
Okay.
Yeah, what parks be brie, parks and think, be brie, a honum. Meta, be do be na say a bobola. No matinas in my head. Into a dog or park, I have a lot of pictures. I meet one of my many boys in a football. And na say ya crampo ye will league ye bo
okay
ye bo utating a lee park and say ya wish me show so come Facebook where be
yes.
Ma mu footballs ni jerseys near be omu yen annually. Na in fact the best players come from my constituency. Just say I can say ye bit me push your mu into ye bibia me share nim say. Minya ye me astroturf ni via and no project a dummy ni super say ye we are. Ye be developing your leagues and say my packy jerseys, my packy footballs are ye nya start ya pe ye best at ye developing properly. Send ye bay ye bit me ama your friends a one more recruiting footballers.
Almost scouts.
Almost scouty. No more bar, no more be ye mano. Na omo to me develop your mo. Na mean so me to me the me mana kwa bridge. Because I know na me pe. Inti ano de ye buy a hot dia. I think the best footballers.
Finally, before you go, MPP primaries, November 4th.
Yes. Dr. Baumia, he will win.
Dr. Baumia will win.
Yes. There's no doubt. But that is what Ghana needs. He is what Ghana needs at this time. Does that sound in your Bible? Because Esther, you are what we need at this time. You came for such a time as this. He is the perfect, excellent person to lead this country. For all of us,
Honorable Sheila Batels, and a premier,
it is possible.
It. Honorable Sheila Batels, it's very, very fun having a conversation with you. And I've actually enjoyed our conversation this morning. I'm gonna say, you graced our studios. It's been an interesting conversation. How did you make any BCM?